Hello, my name is Viktorija and here is Gabrielė. And I would like to tell you a story. While I was still studying at the university, my aunt came to visit me. She admired my tiny, cozy student-type apartment that I was renting. She looked around the room, when suddenly she stopped in front of one of the room, of the walls. There were inspiring quotes, photos, meaningful to me, posted on it. One of those stickers said, 1 + 1 = 1. You know, I was overcoming a bit difficult moment in my life and of my youth love, but my aunt didn't know that. That sticker, 1 + 1 = 1, meant to me a scene of the movie we had watched together with my ex-boyfriend. I cherished that memory a lot, I think you imagine. And my aunt was a teacher. So, after seeing the sticker, she said, wrong answer. And she took a red marker and corrected the mistake. Although I was asking her not to do that. I think she even didn't think at the moment that correcting the mistake broke my heart. And I'm sure that she didn't think about that sometimes mathematics and life can be so strongly connected. I want to be a different kind of a teacher. I want that my students would know how to overcome their fears, how to be brave and smart. Mathematics can help them to become brave. Once, with my second grade students, we had a chance to experience that. You know, math strikes you everywhere, even if you're traveling. So we were reading a book and decided to follow the footsteps of the hero. As a hero was a giant, we had to climb the hills that were made by him. You know, those hills were pretty high. And on top of that, some of kids realized that they're afraid of height. There were no other way how to go downstairs. What to do? What would you do? So we decided we shall count steps. Kids were so concentrated in counting the steps that they even forgot about the fear, because they were trying not to lose their number. When we came back to the school, kids compared their numbers, and then later we draw charts. So they learned the new mathematical material as well as they developed some virtues: attentiveness, bravery, and mathematics. You know, we want that our children would be people who are asking questions, lots of questions, because then they can understand that they can become scientists and investigators and have fun. So I want that my kids would have a feeling of amazingness, that something is going on in your life, and they would have, you know, joy of doing those things. I remember that once, in the end of the school year, we decided, of course, kids voted for that, that we are going to watch the movie, Disney movie, Mary Poppins. They were very, very excited about the word supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. You know, they were still giggling and laughing. We discussed what does that word means, and then we counted letters. Could you guess right now how many letters are there? Who got 34? Raise your hand. We know that mathematics is kind of art. Being a teacher is kind of art as well. Because then you inspire your kids and they become sensitive for the world, what's going on. Mathematics is a secret way that leads to challenges as well.
And it is expected that we talk about values such as friendship, trust, during literature classes, love for nature during science. But then math, numbers, operations, and values. So the question is, what more does math bring to us? How does the value really value? I once gave my students a task. They had to find 15 different geometric figures or dimensional forms in the school. They worked in pairs and had a camera per pair. Children carried out this task very creatively. They even asked other teachers to help them to make shapes using their bodies and pose for the pictures. One, for example, became a triangle. This was fun and useful not only for the students, but for the teachers as well. Children intuitively found out that if you are not afraid and you try, there is always a solution for every problem you face. There is one necessary condition for that. You should come out of your comfort zone. Bingo! Assignment done, comfort zone widened, ready to go further. And do you know a universal language? I definitely think it's maths. We meet so many different people in our lives, but how do we treat people who are not like us? What is the key? While analyzing human body topic, me and my students decided to find out how well a human body was proportioned. They measured each other's height, weight, drew palms, soles, body silhouettes on the paper. And for some of the tasks, it was not so easy to make it on your own. It's not so easy to draw yourself while laying on the ground or measure your own height. So they helped each other. And student said to me after that, it did not matter what your height, weight, language, beliefs, color were. These things do not affect a relation with a human being. So tolerance and respect is the key. It is not only about being polite or protecting from something unpleasant. It's about inviting to play or helping, they told me. Once we made a decoding task with my students. What is it, you may ask? They coded themselves. Have you ever considered saying to others, "Hello there, my name consists of 8 letters. I was born on 2nd month of the year, on 15 plus 13 day." That's what they did. They draw diagrams and wrote their guesses. It was really fun to watch them guessing and seeing the joy after a friend was decoded. Yeah, it was really interesting for them. And then they got that we're so different and we still make a good team. Actually, this is why we make a good team, because of being good at different things. And later I asked them whether they all wanted to be the same. One student told me, "Teacher, maybe it would be easier for you or some others if we all were the same." I laughed. Teaching is not about that. And you know, math and values is not something we learn. It just surrounds us every day. There are students who sometimes need help. Actually, this is a very common situation in every classroom. And you finish your task, teacher congratulates you, and you can enjoy your 15 minutes break. But there are still some students who have not done their work yet. What would you choose to do in this situation? Go and enjoy your free play. Or maybe help a friend. I remember one case in my classroom. One girl finished her task and said that she could help to others who have not completed yet. And she did not care about going to play. What she mattered was to help, rather than go enjoy a free play. And help, what is help? Help is not solving a problem for a friend. Help is considered then you help your friend construct a way to solve a problem. If you could only see how happy they were when they went to play together after completing the task. And this happens really often in our daily lives. And I guess happiness is something that is only real when it is shared.
I believe that in future there will be a lot of new technologies that would leave us speechless today. But the most important thing we want our kids to teach is the love of life. We want them to be smart and brave. We want them that they would respect each other and other people. We want them to learn how to collaborate and how to work as a team. I just remember one simply beautiful example. It happened in our school. Kids had to build friendship bridges. So the hints of the task were hidden in the class, and then fun began. The level of the sound increased till the maximum because everybody wanted to be in charge and they could hear only themselves. It took a little while for them to understand that it was a wrong way to complete the task. So, suddenly, small groups started to emerge. And they shared their work, what they have to do. Teachers were just looking, what's going on? It was so amazing, because the level of the sound decreased till minimum, till silence, and you could hear only scribbling of pencils. They discussed about friendship. They wrote poems, incredible poems, sensitive and profound. We were so proud of our kids because such a little people, but enormous wisdom. And you know, the task was so related to mathematics and values, but they didn't realize that. In the end of the day, working really hard, suddenly they said, won't be math today? You know, it was a simple task, just to build, count, measure the bridge, to decorate it, write all over it. But however, it happened many more things. They learned how to build relations, how to listen to each other, and how to respect each other.
When we look and see the whole picture of a child, we have a vision. What he or she is going to be like in the future. We know we are on the right way, then we like what we see. Yet, what is it what we want to see? We want them to enjoy learning, to be smart citizens, simply be happy. We want them to learn things that really matter. Thank you very much.